Hi, I'm Neff. In this video, we're going to create a super simple inventory app from a couple of Google Sheets and using Google App Script. So to jump into our use case, we're going to pretend that you have three delicious sandwich shops, and you'll need to create two apps in Google App Script to manage shop inventory based off of your two Google Sheets. So for the first app, you have a workbook with all of the different ingredients. The shop manager is then responsible for inputting the number of each ingredient that needs to be purchased and delivered. And then the second app is for the person that's doing the shopping. So it's going to compile the totals of each ingredient to create a master shopping list. And then finally, we're going to create a UI that shows how much of each ingredient needs to be delivered to each shop. So if this sounds interesting, comment down below Google App Script to get the templates and the code. And let's jump in. All right, so before I jump in, I'm gonna give you a quick high-level view of the different parts that we're going to need, and then show you the finished product and what it looks like. First, we're going to need two Google Sheets. One is going to contain the number of ingredients that are input by the shop manager, like we see up here. It contains one sheet, and then we're going to need a second Google Sheet, and this is going to have two sheets. The first one is the shopping list. So this sums up the number of ingredients that we're going to need. And then the other sheet is called delivery list. So this pretty much just replicates the same values from the first sheet that we see here. And then with this information, we pass over to our UI. So here we have the master shopping list. So this is intended to the person that's doing the shopping, right? That's going to be ordering the different ingredients. And then the delivery list is to the person that's going to be delivering the ingredients to each shop to know how much of what needs to be delivered to which store. All right, with that said, I'm going to quickly show you how you can set this up for your instance. So first, what you want to do is either recreate this file or do a make copy from the template that I provided, and then also do the same for the master shopping list. I think it's easier to just make a copy because then you don't have to worry about naming conventions or any further adjustments that you have to do in the Google App Script. So after you create those first two Google Sheets, the next thing that you'll want to do is create your Google App Scripts. So I'm going to head over to that first Google Sheet and I'm calling it Ingredients Inventory and head up to Extensions and then select App Script. So the next thing that you'll want to do is replace the IDs from your two Google Sheets. So here is my Ingredients Inventory spreadsheet. So it's that first spreadsheet that I shared with you. Here is the text string and it ends in E0. So if I head over to that Google Sheet and head up to the URL, you can see that you can copy and then paste that value back into your Google App Script. And then you'll do the same process for that second Google Sheet that I'm calling Master Shopping List. So that's it in terms of setup. But if you want to dive in deeper and kind of see what the code is doing, it's very well documented. It has very descriptive comments. So feel free and read up on what the code is doing. Okay, so the next thing that we need to do is set up the trigger that's going to run the script. So we'll go over to triggers over here and then add a trigger. So I have mine set up like you see up here. And we're going to choose a function. So we only have one function. Let's select that one. This one's already set to run at the head. And then the event source is going to be spreadsheet. And then the event type will be on edit. So anytime there's an edit on that spreadsheet, on the inventory spreadsheet, it's going to run that code. And then on any failure, I want to be notified immediately when that happens. So I'm going to click on save, and then we're going to go back to the editor to test out the code and make sure that it runs properly. So before I do that, I'm going to delete these values here. So we know that everything is working as expected. And then we'll go back to our script. We're going to run the script. And in the execution logs, we can see that it started and that it completed. So let's go to our master shopping list. and we can see that it updated with 28, and then it also populated the values, right? So let's test this out one step further. So what we're going to do is we're going to add a few more ingredients, or not ingredients, but values to each ingredient. So it's 28, right? So if we go to our first spreadsheet, ingredients inventory, let's say that we want to do 202 and 20. So that should automatically populate the values up here. So you can see that it went from 28 to 37. And then if we go over to our delivery list, it pretty much replicates the same values. Okay, so that takes care of the first portion of creating that Google app script. So the next thing that we want to do is create that UI. So that's going to require the second app, and then we're going to create kind of like the index HTML side, which creates this UI that you see here. All right, so here we are in the shopper app in the app script. So to get there, you probably want to go to your master shopping list, go to extensions, and then click on app script. And then that links up the script to the Google Sheet. So if we go back to the shopper app, all we need to do is update the ID. So you'll go to your master shopping list sheet and just copy and paste the value right here. So if you read through the comments, you can see what the code is doing. It's pretty much just replicating the same items from that first spreadsheet of ingredients inventory over to the master shopping list. And then down below, this is where it starts to create the template, the UI template. So we require a file called index that you see up here, and this is where it is. So if you click, so you're gonna have to create a new file. You call it index.html with the capital, because that's how we refer to it in the code. You'll notice that it's a capital I, and we pass in this code. And here you can kind of go bananas and style it the way that you want. What I provided is a super simple, not so ugly way of presenting the data. Feel free and style it and format it the way you want. But the end product is going to look like this, right? So in order to get the link to this page, we have to do one more step. So if we head back, what we need to do is deploy this as a web app. So go over to deploy, go to new deployment, and then here you pass in a description. This could be, you know, like the last change that you made, just to kind of, if you want to refer back to a previous version. And then we are going to select who has access to this thing. So in your case, if you're just kind of testing things out, you can just put it only myself or anyone with a Google account, or in this case that I'm sharing here, anyone with a web connection can access that dashboard. So go ahead and deploy. And then once you deploy, this is where you get your URL. So you'll copy this and then you'll put it into your browser, and then you'll see the data here. So let's do one more test just to make sure that this thing is working properly. So we have the value of 37 for each ingredient in that master shopping list. So if we go back to that ingredients inventory, and let's put 30 this time, and then go to our master shopping list. So this got updated, the shopping list got updated to 47, and then our script, let's go ahead and refresh that, it got updated to 47. So that's it for this video. If you have any questions or comments, I'd love to hear from you down below. Until then, I'll see you in the next one.